Hi, this is Sheshanan. Welcome to Eritech Solutions. Let's see the application with microcontroller by using microcontroller. So this application regards 00 to 99 on 2-digit 7-segment display. So most of the cases you need to run counters by using these 7-segment units. So let's see this application block diagram. This contains three individual blocks. One is power supply unit and microcontroller unit and 2-digit 7-segment display unit. Whereas power supply unit required to convert your AC source into DC source. So whereas again the internal sections of power supply is very clear. One is rectifier and filter and regulators. Rectifier, again you have to take bridge rectifier, full wave rectifiers. It converts your AC to pulsating DC, but this is not pure DC. So this pulsating DC, which is filtered through capacitors, electrolytic capacitors. Electrolytic capacitor allows AC and blocks DC. So whatever the ripples which is maintained by your pulsating DC, which is given to ground through this electrolytic capacitor. The block DC which is passing through regulators. Regulators gives constant output irrespective of any input. Whereas microcontroller and 7-segment displays required 5 volts DC constant output. So that I am taking DC 5 volt supply from power supply block. Whereas microcontroller unit contains some standard connections, whereas reset circuit components. Between 18 and 19 pins, you need crystal oscillator, and for reset pin, you have to go with RC combination by adding button. So just by doing this minimum connections with microcontroller, you can start interfacing external peripherals. Whereas 2-digit 7-segment display contains common data lines A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, which is dot pointer H, and two common pins. So let's see the complete circuit diagram of this. Before proceeding circuit, so you should know how to deal with these 7-segment devices. So this table is mandatory for your 7-segment units. So if you are trying to display any number on 7-segment, you have to follow this lookup table. So now I am working with common anode in my application. So whereas common anode which required to activate your segment logic 0, because common pin is already given to VCC because it is a common anode. So each segment requires logic 0 to turn on. If I am expecting 0 number on 7 segment, then so just calculate your hexadecimal value to display 0 on your 7 segment digit. Now if you are trying to display 0, 0xc0 is the hexadecimal value you need to assign for your data lines. If you are trying to display 1, f9, for number 2, a4, for number 3, b0, number 4, 99, number 5, 92, number 6, 82, number 7, F8, number 8, 80, number 9, 90. So as per your number, you have to calculate these hexadecimal values. So these hexadecimal values you need to use in program to get your proper numbers on display. Now come to the circuit. So let's see how I connected this 2-digit 7 segment with microcontroller. So the data lines A2H, which is DP dot pointer, given to one complete port from microcontroller, which is port 2, and two common pins are given to connection, which is P3.0 and P3.1. So this hardware connection you have to do between microcontroller and 2-digit 7-segment display. Now, so let's see the source code of this circuit, how to display or how to start my counting process from 00 to 99 by using this microcontroller and 7 segment combination. So the program which is already developed in Keil Microvision for this application. So Keil Microvision is one popular IDE for all microcontroller programming. So this IDE supports most of the manufacturers. Using this IDE, you can develop your source code and you can create final .hex file. So your microcontroller doesn't execute your C programs or assembly language programs directly. You need to create .hex file. So for that, you have to do all these steps, text editor and compile the program, and let's say make it zero errors, zero warnings for your program, and finally you have to create one hex file by setting the options from target one. So let's see the program, which is hash include RGG51.h, which supports to use all SFR registers from microcontroller. You know that basically any feature you are trying to program for your microcontrollers, you should know about this list of SFRs. SFR name itself, special function registers. So these registers allows to program your features of microcontroller. So whenever you are trying to use all registers, you need to include this header file. And the two common pins I am using individually. So any SFR register you are trying to access individually, any single bit you are trying to use this standard data type SBIT. SBIT stands for single bit from SFR. But always you have to check your SFR is bit addressable or not bit addressable. If register is not bit addressable, you cannot access individual bits. Any SFR register supports bit addressable, then only you can declare with this SBIT data type. Now I am taking two individual IO pins for two common pins. One for common 1 and second pin for common 2. And one user defined function which is delay. Main logic starts from here. Say this is one array I am taking here with the index 10. So these values from where I got, this is from lookup table of 7 segment common anode. Suppose if you are dealing with common cathode, the values might be different. You have to prepare your own values as per your number from 7 segment. So these values are from 0 to 9. 0 equivalent value is C0 from your lookup table. So all these values I just saved in program. So these values from 0 to 9, and three temporary variables I am taking, V1, V2, V3. The initial logics of port 2 I am assigning as zeros, and common pins logics also zeros. Now I am entering into one infinite loop, which is while of 1. So how I am trying to display writing this logic here is a very simple logic. The two inner for loops I am taking. The first for loop I am comparing with 10, and the second inner for loop I am taking with V2 variable, first V1 variable and V2 variable. And again I am taking one more inner for loop. This is for executing my logic 20 times so that you can watch your numbers on 7 segment up to particular time. If you are not giving this, the values you can observe from hardware is more quick. If you want to wait some time, the same lines you need to execute up to some time. To execute these lines 20 times, I can watch my numbers on 7 segments as 00 properly. So these two inner for loops will help us. First inner for loop will help you to execute same lines 20 times, and this for loop will allow us to change the number on first segment 0 to 9. Whenever it reaches 0 to 9 and the execution goes to the top for loop, it increments by 1. So that you can change the numbers after 0, 9, you will get 1, 0 on 7 segment. Again, it repeats 9 times and this inner for loop will hold some time your numbers on 7 segment. Let's see, I am activating first common pin and I am giving the value of segment of V1, which means initially V1 is 0, so that it reads the first element of your array, which is 0xc0 on port. So that in the first digit you will get 0 display. And this delay you have to provide between switching common pins. So common pins also you have to switch with proper time delay. So always delays will play the major role whenever you are handling multiple 7 segments. So if you are not giving proper time delays between switching, you cannot manage your 7 segments proper display. So don't confuse this for loop for executing my lines more number of times and this delay for switching my common pins one to another. Initially V1 is 0, V2 is 0, so that you'll get 0, 0 display on 7 segment. So this entire process will execute 20 times, so that on 2 digits you can watch 0, 0 sometimes. And later V2 only increments by 1, so that V1 remains 0 and V2 incremented by 1, so that you can get the number on 2 digits as 0, 1. And this process will execute 20 times, so that you can watch sometime your response. And delay, I am just taking one self for loop up to some time. So after completion of this 10 times execution, then V1 increments by 1, so that you can get the numbers from 0 to 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 0, 5, 0, 6, 0, 7, 0, 8, 0, 9, later 1, 0. Because you are repeating, you are incrementing V1 value by 1 after reaching 10. So this, if you are trying to see the response of this program with hardware, you need to create a hex file. So hex file creation process is very clear. Just right click on target and give the oscillator frequency whatever you are connecting across microcontroller, and click on this output tab and highlight this create hex file option. Click on OK and build it. Now it will give you your creating hex file with project name. If you want to check this logic output with simulation tool, there is a one popular simulation tool which is available on Google, which is Proteus. The Proteus simulation tool will help us to check your hardware results with the help of software. Most of the microcontrollers it supports, including Arduino, PIC microcontrollers, ARM controllers, LPC2148, STM32. So any microcontroller you can test with this Proteus simulation tool with the peripherals. Now just do your hardware connections with microcontroller and 2 digit 7 segment. Double click on controller, it will ask one program file path. So just click on this folder and link your hex file and click on play button. Let's see, this is holding time from logic, you're repeating 20 times this execution, otherwise it should be more quick, you cannot watch properly. So this first for loop is 0 to 9 and this for loop will increment by 1 after reaching 10, 0 to 9. So this process it continues up to 99. This is how you can check your hardware results with your Proteus simulation tool. For more videos, please subscribe our channel Aerotech Solutions from YouTube. Please give your valuable feedback as comment. Please like and share us. We are giving continuous videos on different microcontrollers. and peripheral interfacings. And if any training related things, you can get back with this number 9676327118 for any training related requirements or placements and development and projects and components for any related services. You can get back with this number through WhatsApp or hand phone. If you want to reach our office, so you are located at Housing Board Metro Station, Kukatpally, Hyderabad. If you want to write any queries, please email us ysnanda@airtechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.